Give me a minute. I want to talk about something serious here for a second. And it gives me no pleasure to do this, but it's important that we acknowledge what's really happening in the world and not let ourselves be blinded by nonsense and propaganda. And what's really happening in the world today is that Russian soldiers are dying at a rate of 1,000 a day some days. And the evidence for it is right here. These are pictures of Russian military cemeteries. This one is from October of 2021. Here's the same cemetery from December of 2022. You see all those new graves? You see all those new plots prepared? You see how much denser everything is? That's real. That's real life and death right there. Here's another one. This is from Tula, October of 2021. And you can see there's monuments at regular intervals across this space, but much of this space is just grass. Now we take a look. Tula from April 2023. Now bear in mind, this is a year ago. There's been a whole year come and gone since this picture was taken. And look at from 2021 to 2023, look at how many more monuments there are. Look how this area is all dug up now with fresh graves. And there's been a whole nother year since then. This is probably the most striking. This one is from October of 2021. And you can see basically there's just these two areas here that are being used. And then we advance to October 2023, and holy cow. It's awful. It's awful. And this is the price that Russia is paying because their own people won't stand up and be counted. They are too cowed, too intimidated, too afraid to stop it, to stand up and put themselves at risk legitimately. But the power of the people, there are so many more people than there are bureaucrats in the Kremlin and riot police and traitorous soldiers that would shoot their own people. The real patriots, the real Russian patriots right now, the people who really believe that Russia has a future, that Russia can be freed from fear and from poverty and terror and dictatorship, are at this very moment fighting in Kursk and Belgorod against Russian regulars. The Russian civil war has begun, and it's happening right now, and it's real. And do not believe the trolls who tell you that they've all been unalived. They have not been unalived. They're in charge. They're in charge of at least two towns, and they appear to be on the move, which I didn't think would happen. I thought for sure they'd do what they always do. They cross the border, they grab a bunch of shit that they need, vehicles, ammunition kind of stuff, and they get back over to Ukraine where it's safe. No, not this time. This time they are vowing to march to Moscow for the elections. Wow. Now, there's no way they can do that. At best, there's 6,000 of them. They can't face the whole Russian army. How is that a thing? So they've got some kind of plan, these guys. And I hope that that plan involves a whole bunch of real patriotic Russians, not Kremlin apologists and slaves who will simply march to their own unaliving because the Kremlin and Putin tell them to, but rather the real Russian men who will stand up and point their guns in the right direction at their enemies in the Kremlin. Those are the real enemies. That's who's doing this to you. That's whose fist is up your ass, Russia. Take them down. Or this is the only future you have.